Okay, thanks, Gavin. Well, that was I Was Born to Love You, and I have the man here himself, Freddie. Welcome to Countdown.
Hi.
Hello, Molly.
What an outrageous film clip.
It's all to do with me.
How long did that film clip take to do?
It took 3 days, all in all. But, I mean, they were very, very heavy sessions. I mean, I was up till 6 in the morning. I would start about 8. So 8 in the morning and then go all the way around the clock.
Now, David Mallet, who's obviously known for David Bowie's stuff out here, and who came out here and, in fact, filmed it. Now, was it his idea or your idea?
It was my idea. Now, actually, it's a combination of both. Because a lot of the stuff took place on the actual set, you know,
right.
Different ideas and all that. But it's a combination. We worked on it for weeks beforehand. But then a lot of it just took place while we were on the set.
Well, I think it's a sensational song and an equally sensational film clip, even though it may be a bit over the top. But talking about sensations, it's gone.
I think it's quite mild, actually. Yeah.
Well, there you go. This week it's hit number 14, first weekend on the British charts. Not bad.
Not bad.
And talking about chartbusters, let's have a look at the chartbusters for this week. Well, thanks, Gavin. The Tribe, even in Russia, from the Countdown Studios. I'm talking about Russia. Have you ever been to Russia?
No. I think we'd like to go. I think we tried to go there so several years ago, but I think they looked at our sort of videos and things and they said no, because I think they probably thought we were going to corrupt their youth.
Right.
Things like that. So I don't think they're quite ready for us yet. They better make up their minds quite quick.
Well, talking about making up your minds, there's a lot of new groups coming up, especially on the English charts, because the English charts seem to sort of happen so fast.
I mean, know, it's cutthroat.
Yes, it certainly is. And there's one group called Go West.
Yeah.
They've got a new single out there at the moment that's doing very well. But you obviously know
a bit about this. Well, I've seen one of their clips, actually, and heard a couple of their songs. I think they're going to be very, very big.
Right.
I do. I think they're going to be very, very big. They're in that sort of, these sort of duos seem to be coming across quite a lot. Duos like sort of Wham or Tears for Fears, and I think Go West are another, it's like a two-piece band, but they have other members, but it's just the two front people,
right.
And seems to be the trend, doesn't it?
Well, a very unusual film clip produced by Godley and Krem, who made a name for themselves in this. And here they are, Go West with We Close Our Eyes. Now, the next group that's coming up is termed as a heavy metal group, and you're once described as a sort of a glam heavy metal group. Critics, number one, love to put groups into categories. Do you think that's right?
Oh, definitely. I mean, every group that starts off will always get categorized.
Right.
And as far as Queen are concerned, I think we're just about everything. We do heavy metal, we do ballads, we do... So, I mean, I don't know. I mean, I guess we're in every category. But some of our songs definitely apply to the heavy metal category.
Well, I mean, around the world, I mean, not only in England and America, and especially here as well, there are sort of like sections who just love heavy metal.
Very true, very true.
And they actually don't like anything else.
That's,
but
that's
there
problem.
Was a lot of them in your audience, I noticed.
Yeah, because I mean, they're definitely a cross-section because we play heavy metal stuff too. But I mean, I'd like people to think that that's not all we do. But I know, because we started off on a sort of heavy metal footing, and in the days of Led Zeppelin and everything.
Right.
I think that Led Zeppelin is still one of the greatest heavy metal band that I believe.
Well, the next act coming up is Howard Jones, and there seems to be, on the English charts alone, and having an influence on the American and Australian charts, a lot of good singer-songwriters that are doing ballads. I mean, ballads at one stage, say 2 or 3 years ago, just simply would not work on the charts.
Mm.
Who would you consider as one of the best singer-songwriters? In England?
In England?
Yeah.
No, well, I think right now George Michael is very, very good. But I mean, Stevie Wonder, well, obviously he's not from England, but
right.
I mean, he just, for writing a ballad, you know, you just can't top that guy. But there's several.
Paul Young?
I think Lionel Richie.
How would you consider Paul Young as a singer?
Paul Young's very good,
yeah.
He does a lot of covers, though, doesn't he? I mean, he's got a beautiful voice.
Yeah.
I don't know about his writing talent. I mean, I'm sure he writes.
Well, actually,
his cover version seemed to be the best.
You were talking about your own voice, you know, it takes the stress. Paul Young had a breakdown with his voice last year, and in fact the critics said he'd never sing again.
Mm. So I think he was worried as well.
Yeah, he was.
I remember, because I think he probably had the same thing that I did, basically.
Right.
I mean, but he actually had an operation. But if they're nodules, you can have an operation, but they still come back.
Well, thank you, Gavin. You seem in good form there, mate. And
thank you.
I tell you what, Freddie, it's going to be hard to knock We Are the World off number one spot. number one around the world.
It's a very good song.
Great song. In fact, a lot of people, funny enough, when this was being recorded and I was over in America and went to that session, some people thought it was a rather naff song that Lionel Richie and Michael had written.
Oh, no, not at all. I think it's a beautiful song, and I was gripped by the video, because, I mean, it's nice to have all those stars, you know, and no sort of... There were no ego trips, to be honest. I mean, they're just going from one to the other. It was lovely to see all the stars all together. And I think it's a beautiful song, really.
Well, finally, I must say, thanks for coming on the program. It's been great to have Queen out in this country. You've given us, I mean, an utmost delight as performance. I don't know how you can keep it up night after night.
Well, I think I'm glad I came back. And I think the audience has enjoyed it. It was nice to play.
They certainly did.
Nice to play after all these years.
We'll come back soon. Don't leave it so long.
Do my best.
Okay. So it's good night from Freddie.
Good night.
And it's good night from me. And we're not going out with the number one because you've already seen it. We're going out, and I hope it doesn't take you 50 years to get here for the next trip. It's the Uncanny X-Men, that Brian Mannix again, and here he is, and the group with 50 Years. Good night, Australia.
Good night.